back and bring your elbows like you're trying to drive them back towards your hips. Grow nice and tall to the crown of your head. Take a big inhale. Next one, we're going to turn to look over the right shoulder. Inhale back to center. Exhale, turn your toe. Inhale, center. And exhale to the right. Inhale, center. Lift your chest off of your mat and exhale. Inhale, squeeze those shoulder blades back. Press the tops of your toes into your mat and exhale. Release. Good. One more, just like that. Big breath in. And big breath out. All right, so from here, if you want to, you can always push up onto your knees to your tabletop. If you want more of a challenge, go ahead and curl your toes under. And walk your feet until your hips lift off the mat. Take an inhale breath and exhale, push up to high plank pose. Stay for the inhale. And exhale, bend your knees, send your hips high, and then relax. Go ahead and start to find a little movement in your feet here by dropping one heel. One more breath to move in. And out. On your next inhale, lift your heels up high to the sky. And exhale, sink those heels down towards the mat. We're going to move a little bit into our shoulders before we stay in this down dog. So your next inhale, about take your gaze to your hands and shift forward to high plank pose. And exhale, bend your knees, send your hips high, down dog. Inhale, look forward, shift forward, high plank. Exhale, bend your knees, send your hips high, down dog. One more, just like that. Inhale, look forward, shift forward, and exhale, hips high, down dog. So we're going to stay for a few breaths here in this downward dog. Just some checkpoints with your hand, with your positioning. So make sure those hands are still spread nice and wide. Pull your shoulder blades down and away from your ears here. Sink those heels down into the mat. And bend your knees enough so that the hips are the highest point of your pose. Let's take a big breath in. And a big breath out. Big inhale. Big exhale. One more, just like that. Inhale. Inhale, breath, take your gaze to your hands, and exhale, go ahead and slowly walk your feet up to meet your hands at the top of your space. Once you get there, use heel toe your feet as wide as your mat. Give yourself a little more space in your hips for this first forward fold. Then from here, bend your knees a lot and fold over your legs so that your thighs touch your torso. You can grasp opposite elbows here if that feels good to you, or you can let your facing towards your mat. If you would like to find a little bit of organic movement, you can shift right to left, or even forward and back on your feet. Just find some movement that feels good in your hips and your lower back, your hamstrings. Find your deep breath. We'll take one more breath here. Stillness now. Go ahead and release your hands down to the mat. From here, we're going to take an inhale breath and shift the weight into the balls of our feet. Come up for a halfway lift. Squeeze those shoulder blades back. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale brings you up to a halfway lift. Nice flat back. And exhale, fold. One more, just like that. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale. From here, go ahead and heel toe your feet to about hip width distance apart. You can measure that by taking two fists in between your big toes. Then here, we're going to take another inhale to a halfway lift, and then exhale, we're going to stay. So imagining that you have a super flat back that I could rest a glass of water on. Take a big inhale breath, grow long from the top of your head to the tip of your tailbone, and exhale. Another one, big inhale, big exhale. Then one more deep breath in, and exhale, fold forward. From here, go ahead and inhale, and let your arms hang, slowly begin to stand up for Tadasana, mountain toes. Thinking about stacking one vertebrae on top of the other. Once you get there at the top, I'm going to start to roll the shoulders back. Big circles. And then we'll go the other way. Some of that tension that I'm sure this week has brought. Alright, and then when you find stillness, go ahead and inhale and lift your arms up high to the sky. Exhale, grab that left wrist and we're going to send it over to the left. Just a little bit. Tiny one for the first one. Inhale, come back through center. And exhale, find a little more space. Send that left hip toward the chin. Inhale, back to center. And exhale, find more space. Inhale, back to center. Last one. Exhale to the right. Stay for the inhale. Exhale, so you can send that left hip just a little bit more towards the gym. Hug your shoulder blades back, so make sure you can see your neck. Big breath in. Big breath out. One more just like this. Big inhale. Big exhale. Inhale, use the strength of your core to bring yourself back up to your center. And then we'll switch. Exhale, work those shoulder blades down away from your ears. Inhale, grow tall through the crown of your head. And exhale, send it to the left. Inhale, come back to center. And exhale, find a little more space. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, find more space. Inhale, back to center. And now exhale, find more space. Stay on your inhale. Big breath in. Send that right hip towards the stereo wall. Exhale. Hug those shoulder blades down away from your ears. Inhale. Make sure you can see your neck. Exhale. One more right here. Big inhale. Big exhale. Inhale to bring yourself back up to standing straight. So we're going to goal post the arms and almost hug your heart underneath your, I don't know what I'm saying. Use your shoulder blades to hug underneath your heart. That's what I'm saying. Big inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, goal post those arms, send the hips forward. Exhale. Inhale, bring yourself back up. Use your core. And exhale, find a little more space. So we're really squeezing the shoulder blades together here. Big inhale, reach up. And exhale, squeeze some hips forward. Now we're going to stay here. Big inhale. And exhale. Use the strength of your core. Engage those core muscles. Big breath in. Squeeze the glutes, exhale. Good, one more just like this. Big inhale. And exhale. On your next inhale, use the strength of your core to bring yourself back up through center. And then exhale, dive forward or forward fold. Inhale brings you to a halfway lift, nice flat back. And exhale, plant your hands, step back for high plank. Take a big breath in here. And exhale, hinge slightly forward, hug those elbows in, lower halfway down. And we're going to inhale to upward facing dog. And exhale, set the hips high. Let's take a big breath in here. And a big breath out. A big step up to meet your hands on top of your space. Inhale brings you to a halfway lift. And
artificial root blades down your ears or away from your ears. Wow, I can't talk today, guys, so thanks for staying with me. We're going to shift the weight to the right leg. On your next inhale, pick up that left foot. Go ahead and roll out the ankle. You can flex and point the toes. Roll it in different directions. Just play a little bit with your balance. Good. When you're ready, find some stillness. Let's take a big inhale. Squeeze into that right glute. Exhale. Big breath in. Big breath out. Inhale, breath, and straighten that front leg. And exhale, bend it. Big inhale, straighten and lengthen. And exhale, bend. Good. Inhale, straighten and lengthen. And exhale, bend. Now we're going to inhale, straighten and lengthen, and hold. Exhale, squeeze those shoulder blades back. Big inhale. Big exhale. Good. Lift that leg up a little higher. And then exhale. Good. One more big breath in. And big breath out. Now we're going to hinge on this leg, so keep this right left leg lifted. We're going to hinge back and send it back and touch that right toes. So half standing splits here. Sorry, standing splits here. So bring both hands down in front of you, directly underneath your shoulders. From here you can place either your fingertips down or full hands, whatever is more comfortable for you. But look down at your left toes and point both toes or those toes down towards the mat so we level out the hips. Then from here, go ahead and lift that left leg just a little higher. Inhale. And exhale. If this is good enough for you, you can stay here. If you want more of a challenge, you can begin to walk your hands back towards that standing right leg. Take a big breath in. And a big breath out. Big inhale. Exhale. Another big breath in. Take your gaze down to your left foot, and on your exhale, go ahead and plant that foot back there so that we're in a low lunge now. From here, we're going to take an inhale breath and straighten this front leg, looking a little bit into the hamstring. And exhale, bend in for a low lunge. Inhale, straighten this front leg. And exhale, low lunge. Big inhale, straighten the front leg. And exhale, low lunge. All right, real quick, make sure you're still on train tracks and not a tightrope. And when you're ready, go ahead and lift up for crescent lunge. Inhale. All right, so just a little positioning here. You're already on your train tracks. Make sure you're bending your right knee so it's stacked over that right ankle. And you're almost trying to rip your mat in half between the front and the back leg. So there's a lot of tension in the legs. Shoulders are stacked over hips. And when you're ready, reach those arms up high to the sky. Big inhale. Exhale, find a little more space and depth in your lunge. Big breath in. Big breath out. Big inhale. Big exhale. And two more right here. Big breath in. Big breath out. Now on your exhale, rotate that back foot so it's the pinky toe side of it is parallel with the back of your mat. We're going to come to warrior two facing the gym on this side. So just check points. Make sure that your heels are aligned with each other. And then bending that front knee so that the knee is stepped over the ankle and open up the knee. And then so you can see the inside of your right foot. Keep the shoulders stacked over the hips and send the arms forward. Big inhale. Single deep breath. Big breath in. Big breath out. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Big inhale. Big exhale. Good. Two more here. Big breath in. And big breath out. On your next inhale, as I'm pulling you forward from your right arm, we're going to hinge forward. Then bring that right arm to the top of your right knee. Send your left fingertips up high to the sky. Big inhale. And hug your hips underneath your body. Exhale. we're halfway down.
Inhale, upward facing dog.
Exhale, send the hips high. Take a moment here just to notice the difference between the right and the left side. Big breath in. And big breath out.
Very nice. Inhale, breath, take your gaze to your hands. And exhale, hop, step, or jump to the top of your space. Inhale, bring you to a halfway lift. Squeeze those shoulder blades back. And exhale. Inhale, slowly stand up. Mountain pose.
Reach your arms overhead. Exhale, squeeze those shoulder blades down and away from the ears. Right, we're going to move to the other side now, so shift the weight into the left leg. Begin to pick the right foot up. And again, rolling out the ankle, pointing and flexing the foot. It feels good. And then find some stillness. Take a big breath in. Squeeze into that left glute and left quad. Big breath out. Big inhale. Big exhale. Right here. Big inhale. Big exhale. And on your next inhale, we're going to straighten that leg a bit. Again, you can bring hands to hips or stay lifted. And exhale, curl it in. Inhale, straighten the leg. And exhale, curl it in. Inhale, straighten. And exhale, curl. And inhale, straighten. Now stay on the exhale. Big breath in. And take a big breath out. Inhale, lift the leg a little higher. And exhale. And one more big inhale. And big exhale. And begin to hinge forward. Come down for standing splits, so fingertips or hands come directly underneath the shoulders. Check back with that right leg, make sure all five toes are pointed to your mat. Then lift it up to its extent. Then find your breath, inhale. And exhale. If this is enough for you, you can stay here. If you want a little more of a challenge, go ahead and walk your hands back towards your standing left leg. Inhale, lift that right leg just a little higher. And exhale. Another big breath in. And big breath out. One more inhale, lift it up higher. And then look where you're going. Exhale, step that foot back down onto the mat. Make sure you're set up here on train tracks and on a tightrope. Both hands come on either side of that left foot. On your next inhale, we're going to straighten this front leg. And exhale, bend in on a lunge. Inhale, straighten the front leg into the hamstrings, and exhale, the lunge. Inhale, lengthen and straighten, and exhale, the lunge. Now again, just checking in, making sure you're on train tracks. And when you're ready, on your next inhale, we'll come up, crescent lunge. Okay, finding all of our checkpoints again, making sure that that left knee is stacked over the left ankle, creating a lot of tension in this back foot, like we're trying to rip the mat in half. Making sure your shoulders are stacked over your hips. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, sink it just a little deeper. Big breath in. Big breath out. Big inhale. Big exhale. Two more in here. Inhale. And exhale. One more breath in. Now on your exhale, turn towards the stereo wall or warrior two on this side. So heel to heel alignment. That pinky toe side edge of your right foot's in line and parallel with that back corner edge of your mat. Bending your left knee enough so that it stacks over the left ankle and you can open it so you can see the inside of your left foot. Inhale, reach forward and back. And squeeze those shoulder blades together like you're trying to get your pinkies to touch behind you. Let's take a big inhale breath. Exhale, find a little more depth in your lunge. Ripping the mat in half between your front and your back leg. Inhale. And exhale. Another deep breath in. And deep breath out. On your next inhale breath, like I'm grabbing you from your
left wrist, let's hinge forward, and left, and rest the left elbow on top of the left knee. Inhale, reach the right fingertips up high to the sky. And exhale, hug your hips underneath your body. Doing a little more of a stretch in your armpit on this right side, go ahead and reach your right fingertips towards the front knees. Big inhale. And exhale. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. And the next inhale, rotate up for warrior two. And then cartwheel your arms, plant your hands on either side of that front foot, step back for high plank. Take an inhale breath. And exhale, shift forward and lower halfway down. Inhale, the upper facing dog. Exhale, send those hips high. Downward facing dog. Take a moment here to check in with your body. Notice the spaces you've created. And then catch up a little bit with your breath. Big inhale. And big exhale. Breath in together. And a big breath out. And the next inhale, go ahead and take your gaze to your hands. Exhale, take a step up. Change your hands to the top of your space. Heel toe your feet so that your big toes touch. And there's a little sliver of space between your heels. Inhale brings you to a halfway lift. And exhale. Inhale, slowly roll up to mountain pose. And then we're going to exhale and sit back for chair. So, shifting the weight into your heels, see if you can lift your toes up. And squeeze your inner thighs together. Big breath in. Sink a little deeper, exhale. Big inhale. And exhale. Drop to your knees, knees nice and wide, big toes come to touch. Sink down in the child's pose. Find a moment to catch your breath, notice your breath. On your inhales, expand your belly into your thighs. Thank you.
into a fire log pose. So I'm going to show you guys a couple of stages to this, because this is for the glutes and the glutes need to be pretty tight. So the first stage to this is we're going to cross the right ankle over the left knee. Okay. If this is a lot and you're already feeling it in your glute area, stay here. You don't need to move. If you want a little bit more, struggle to do so, you might need to pull that leg out just a little bit. So big inhale, grow tall, and exhale, drive it down. Inhale, grow tall, and exhale, drive. Two more like this, big breath in, and big breath out. One more, inhale. Out of this, I want you to lean back and extend that left leg long and right leg long. Then we'll move to the other side. So if you guys both want to be crossed, so we're going to first start with the right leg on the ground. Okay, so making sure that that right shin is parallel to our hips. Then taking the left leg on top, so the left ankle is on top of the right knee. So this side might be a little bit different too. So if you need to extend that right leg, comfortable, that's totally fine. Just make sure you notice what's going on in your body. Good. Alright, so we'll take a big inhale. Hand on either side of your hips. Grow tall through the crown of your head. And then exhale, drag both knees down. Big inhale, grow tall. Exhale, drive. Big inhale, breath, grow tall. Challenge, as we all know, like tugging, starting at your core, and trying to sit down one vertebrae at a time as we lay down on our backs, imagining your legs are as heavy as sandbags. If you feel like you're losing control, just go a little slower and find that deep breath. We're going to take happy baby pose, so go ahead and grab the outsides of your feet here. And work those knees at either side of your torso. And really work to keep those shoulder blades on your mat. Let's take a big breath in. And a big breath out. After this breath, you can begin to play if you would like in straightening one leg and then the other, maybe rocking from side to side. Trying to straighten both legs at the same time, whatever feels good in your body, or you can even just stay where you are. Give you a few breaths to play and to move into your body, so big inhale, big exhale, big breath in, big breath out. One more breath here to move. big exhale. Put both knees into your chest. And on your next inhale, go ahead and straighten and lengthen that left leg along your mat. Pull that right knee up into the right armpit. Use your left hand to guide the right knee across your body. So we're coming into a supine twist here. And before we go any further, take your right hand down to your sacrum, your low back area, your hip area, to make sure your hips are stacked one on top of the other. And from here, you can extend the right arm nice and long to the right side of the room. Make sure that that right shoulder is on the mat. And from here, take a big inhale. Inhale, hug both knees into your chest. And exhale, straighten that right leg down along the mat. And inhale, hug that left knee up to the left armpit. Using your right hand to guide your left knee across your body on your inhale. And taking your left hand down, turn your hips, your sacrum area to make sure you're nice and stacked. When you're ready, go ahead and extend the left arm towards the gym wall. That left shoulder on the mat, and let's take a big breath in and a big breath out. Big inhale, big exhale. One more big breath in, big breath out. Your next inhale, hug both knees into your chest. And from here, go ahead and take any last pose that you would like. You'd like, or you go straight into Shavasana, whatever feels good for you. And wherever you're at, please hug both knees into your chest. Squeeze yourself into a nice tight, tiny ball. Take a big inhale breath. And exhale, release into your final Shavasana pose. From here, go ahead and lift slightly up onto your elbows to hug both shoulders down and away from your ears. And then if you are wanting more grounding and more stability today, needing that in your life, in your body, go ahead and go palms face down. If you're needing a little bit more guidance, a little more wisdom, go ahead and go palms face up. If you need a little bit of both, do one on each. Go ahead and take a big breath in. And a big breath out. Release your tongue from the roof of your mouth. And enjoy this final pose. Mm-hmm. gratitude for yourself for making it to this space. And then a moment of gratitude for maybe something you're going through that's challenging today. From here, go ahead and push yourself up into a comfortable seat facing the front of the room. For me, with hands at heart center, eyes closed. Let's take a big breath in together through your nose. Open mouth, exhale. Bring your thumbs to your forehead and bow forward in gratitude. Namaste.
Thank you.
Yeah,
you're welcome.
How does
this
shoulder do?
It hurts here and there.
Yeah? Okay. Nothing too bad though, hopefully?
Uh-huh.
I said nothing too bad though, hopefully, during class?
Well, I avoided making it too bad.
Okay. Good. Awesome. Well, hopefully I'll see you guys next week.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Where do we get your masks? You got some interesting
masks. This one I got off a random website. I think it's funny, so I wore it today because everyone's so tense about the election.
Yeah.
And people are being crazy about it, so I'm like, be nice to each other. Ourselves, you know? no, I got them at a lot of random places. Yeah. Do you need any mask then?
No, I've
got like, I can get you one.
Well, I don't have any masks then.
Oh, there's...
People die if we talk.
Tense right.